So Jeffery Gundlach is taking out a short. He's shorting the S&P 500. Are you going to follow his lead? Or are you going to be a contrarian like I and run the other way? Plus, help! I accidentally took out a mortgage on my house and I used the proceeds to buy USO. So in this video, we're going to look at Jeffery Gundlach's statement. We're going to look at the S&P 500. I'm going to give you my humble opinion on where I think this market is heading, and we're starting right now. Welcome back to your daily dose of stock market insanity, where I can honestly say I don't know what the hell is gonna happen. And if for some reason you like channels on how to start businesses and then make money from those said businesses, then what do we do with that said money? We invest it. You know, maybe we invest in the stock market. Maybe we invest it in offshore drilling of Pokemon cards. I don't know what you fancy, but would you at least just consider subscribing? Now, following Jeffery Gundlach is kind of like following around a bipolar panda bear. You just never know which way they're going. So this is back on March 18th. For the first time in years, I am now not short any U.S. stocks. Okay, so this is right about the time that the whole market crashed. So this is the time that he's like, nope, I am not short on any U.S. stocks. Probably would have been a good time to be short. I covered my last three shorts today at 237. Are you sure it wasn't 236? The profits were just too great to not harvest, and the panic is palpable. Just make sure I said that word right.
Palpable.
Dang it. I screwed
palpable.
It up. Palpable. And for those of you that don't know, I am a high school business teacher, and I cannot palpable. Even pronounce words. Come on, Macklemore, you could have got this. Palpable. We also do Hooked on Phonics on this channel. But here was his exact quote, which I will do my best in reading. Actually, I did just put a short on the S&P at 2,863. By the way, it's gone up since then. At this level, I think, why? Come on. That's a capital I. I know that. I think the upside and downside is very poor. Let me just say that again. At this level, I think the upside and downside is very poor. Which one is it? Is it up or down? Which way are we going on this one? I don't think it could make it to 3,000, but it could. I think downside easily to the lows or beyond. And if it's the Fed, it's to infinity and beyond. I'm not nearly where I was in February when I was very, very short. Well, I'm height challenge two. I get it. And also, as you know, if I can make you laugh, all that I ask is that you just click that little button. But if I don't ever make you laugh, you don't ever have to feel the guilt of having to click the like. And it's kind of funny. Some of you guys leave like comments in the comment section. I like that. Like exactly where you laugh. And then I have to like click because you'll put like a timestamp. I'm like, oh, and then I laugh. I'm like, that was a good one. Johnny Bravo.
Is that now off the table? Is it off the table now, retesting the low because of the Fed?
No, it's not at all. In fact, I think we take out the low. I think a retest of the low was very plausible. A lot of us have been around a lot of years.
Take out the low. So he's calling. We're going a lot farther down.
Almost fell victim to our historical experience and expecting that relatively soon retest of the Dow Jones below 19,000 industrial average. But I just don't think that's going to happen. I think that people don't understand the magnitude of social, I'm not going to say unrest, but social unease, at least, that's going to happen when you have what's now 26 million plus people have lost their job. We've lost every single job that we created since the bottom in 2009.
Yep, that is 100% correct. So it looks like Jeffery Gundlach is going to fight the Fed. What side of this war are you going to be on? You fighting the Fed? Or are you just going to go complete contrarian? Now let's dive into some charts and see which way I'm thinking. But I love it when a man calls the market and then he puts his money where his mouth is. Very clear in saying that we are going to take out the low. That would be down here. Way down here. And we have a huge support and resistance level. I don't know if you can see it. I will draw a big fat line there for you. And I'm also going to show you, if you guys want to trade this, you can short it, meaning you can pick it going down and you can buy it. And you can pick it going up. So SPXL and SPXS I'll go over that momentarily. It's three times. So when the market moves one way, it's three times up, it's three times down. Remember, that means you get to lose your money three times as fast. You can also buy what's called SPY, spiders. I have been invested in the S&P 500 for probably 25 years now. That has been my only, well, besides gold, that has been the only thing that I have hodled. As you know, I'm a trader, I'm not a hodler, and I can't even yodel. So on SPY, it's trading at $287, or the index, the S&P 500 index on TradingView. If you want to know what I'm using, I get a lot of comments like, what is he using? I'm using TradingView.com. You guys can open up a free account. I do have an affiliate link, although I always forget to add it. So we'll open the chart that's 2,878. You're like, $280? What happened to my S&P? So let me draw you a big, fat support and resistance line, because this is where all the action happens. Right about there, which I can add alerts for it. If you want to be a contrarian and think that this market is going to continue higher, you can do so. Now, let me go over some things that, you know, Jeffery might not mention. I'm just going to mention to give you the common sense approach to all of this, even though stock market, there is no common sense approach. And I have to say that if you listen to any of my advice, you will lose one, not dollars, Johnny Bravo, it's percent. You will lose 1,000% of all your money. I'm just a YouTuber. I'm even a high school business teacher. You know what they say about business teachers? It's like they couldn't make it in the real world. So why? You didn't listen to me back then. Why would you listen to me now? So I'm just a teacher. Couldn't make it in the real world. Just listen to your broker over there at Robinhood. Now that guy knows exactly what he's talking about. So step one, Jeffery Gundlach, this area right there. Everyone and their mother is putting in shorts, and we are going to have a squeeze, because more specifically, the amount of resistance that is going to cause is going to be insurmountable. People think it's going to go up, hit that, try again, and fail into the toilet. Or fail into my hair, where we have birds that like to build nests. So I have to say, one for the bears on this resistance line. I would say that there is an 80% probability, if we didn't have this dirty word that starts with the F and ends with the big D, yeah, I'd agree with you. Like 80% probability that this line of resistance, support resistance, is just gonna bang its head right there. And then right down into the bird nest. So we'll do a little scorecard. That's plus one for the shorts. Number two, if you look right here, I added this. I usually don't use volume too much. Is, as you can see, volume is declining. So that means that people are starting to wear out their little fingers. They're starting to get a little tired. The bulls, they can't keep a running. So it's showing that they're starting to kind of give up a little bit. So we'll give another plus one for the shorts. Team shorts versus team Fed. All right, something else that I love, like donuts and cheesecake and ice cream, that needs to be a dessert right there. That's the money. A donut, cheesecake, and ice cream. And right over here on the MACD, right above my shoulder blade, below the bird, it's starting to get tired. Do you see this? Up and down. So we have some momentum right here. All these light bars are like, we're giving up hope. So we're going to give it one more plus for the shorts, unless you guys have hopium, a bottle of hopium, because that will work. When people are losing hope, buy them a bottle of hopium. And number four, right here in this area, this fluster cluck, we're starting to coil. That's what they call it. We're starting to coil. We're coiling up. We got some action coming, and I believe the action is downward, says Jeffery Gundlach. Now, let me erase some of this here. It's getting a little redonkulous. Get rid of the bird. The bird needs to go. This needs to go. We'll just keep the scorecard. And here's another one. See this moving average? Try to keep it simple on this channel. Not too many things going on my chart. There is a 100% probability that this will retest the simple moving average of about 2,699. And that would be in the downward direction. There's a short, a put option of 100 times leveraged all of your life savings. And then also something, this would be the fundamentals, things that are happening in the real world that should actually have a reflection on the stock market, is Nothing is open. And as my grandma would say, everything just went to hell in a handbasket. So the fundamentals of everyone is sucky poo-poo. And I'll give you an example. These are strong fundamentals. Would you not agree? Disney theme park. Sorry about my lines. If I get rid of it, I won't know the scorecard. Disney's theme park are unlikely, theme park, sorry, plural, not singular, are unlikely to open their gates again until 2021, according to analysts, which I typically don't really like to put too much thought into analysts, because if I did, I would probably be broke. And too bad Disney's not part of the FANG stock, otherwise it would be worth bazillions. And I'm sure if I took a look at Disney stock right now, it probably fundamentally took a big bashing. Think it's DSNY if I am right. I am wrong. I think it's DIS. See, there we go. And I'm wrong again. So Disney's never going to reopen and stock vaults higher 5%. But I have a feeling. Let's take a little gander. What has happened in the last 6 months, Tom? And there it is. But it actually was taking a beating before they even threatened to close in the parks. So our high was at 151 and our low was at 85. You would have lost almost half of your money. And talking about money, Bob, he's the CEO. This thing right here, this Federal Reserve note, Federal Reserve currency, this dirty, dirty stuff you guys use that has that virus all over it. It would take one of these to get into Disneyland, including parking. Now you need, what, 200 of them? It shows you that your currency is worthless. You probably shouldn't be putting your currency underneath the mattress over there. That's why I preach investing. So I think that's enough for financials, fundamentals. Let's add this up and see which one wins. For the shorts, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a big thick one, which is 6. So we have 6 for the shorts that the market is heading definitely in the downward direction. And I think the only thing that on the other side of the long position, you could have a squeeze that'll pop this thing up. So we'll give 1 point there. And then since it's the Fed, okay, number one rule is never fight the Fed. The Fed gets 20 points. All right, so let's do the math here. We have 21-6. There it is. There we go. The S&P 500 will hit all-time highs this year with half of America not working. And like I've said 100 bazillion times, there's a big difference between the real economy and the financial economy. And if you want to know how to trade this stuff, my friend Charlie from ZipTrader gives you guys 10% off, 10%. I could just tell you, if we're looking at this on the daily, let's take a little gander. Let's ride this. And up, that would have been, that's where you buy. That's where you close your position. You take that. And then here we go again. And whoop, up, you put in a buy. And you close your position. You lose on that trade. But the good news is, you didn't lose out on that trade. And right here, one candle up. God, that is one thick candle. You put in a buy and you ride this baby all the way to the moon. But I'm not a financial analyst, so I cannot give you the advice on this stuff. Go ahead and take a peek at Charlie's course. The kid's a lot smarter than me, and he doesn't have ugly hair like me. And I did mention that if you wanted to trade this, this is the S&P 500 SPXL for $34.67. This is the share you would want to own. And let me just, I'll leave it at the daily, but I think I may move it to the 4-hour. And then when the market flips and it goes in the other way, you go SPXS, which in February, when you saw this market turn and you're like, wow, Johnny Bravo, this is not looking too good. You would have walked away with 125% on the daily, but you always have trades in one direction or the other. And not too many people trade on the daily. That would be one boring trader. And also, just to let you know, you lose in a lot of trades, but when the winners win, oh, come to papa. So there's your win and there's your loss. So on the shorts, you're kind of waiting. You're waiting. Can we get up above that 20? And the picture, the squigglies that I just drew, let me work something out here for you. See, you're not creative. So you see that as a rock and a hard place. I see this as your friend's dog that has no idea how to trade this stock market because of the Fed. Look how sad that guy is. But remember, oh, that's a terrible smile. What the F did I just do? If I make you laugh one time. I do sell these. All you have to do is hit the thing that says print screen on your keyboard. and then print it out, hang it up in your room. See, look at all these goodies I give you. But those are your two trades. If you just want to sit there on your good old Robinhood app, which I'll leave a link in the description. I'm kidding, I won't. SPXS and SPXL. And since I'm a contrarian, I'm going to just say, what the heck? Put in a buy. Don't listen to anything that I have to say. I've just learned so many times not to listen to analysts, and don't fight the Fed. The Monopoly board game is rigged. The Fed actually has about 7 park places and 10 boardwalks. I don't know why they need 3 extra boardwalks, and they have pockets just loaded with hotels. Yup, and I do have to mention Bitcoin, which most everyone hates, $7,747. And there's only 21 million of them. The halvening's coming up. Few more minutes. You may want to consider that one on the dip. Not financial advice. And unless this is coming from us from the Onion, but it's not. It's the stonk market. Help, I accidentally took out a mortgage on my house and used the proceeds to buy USO. I am in desperate need of help. Here is my dilemma. I accidentally took out a mortgage. I have no idea what to do. I've always been a conservative fella. I even listened to Dave Ramsey and paid off my house in 7 short years, and I've remained debt-free my entire life. I borrowed $250,000. So I started to say the big numbers, and I'm like, nah, I'll just round it for you, and opened up a Robinhood app account and threw it all in USO. I read that USO was, a reverse split, 8-1, not the split you wanted. I thought that it meant I would 8 times my money, and I was wrong. My investment account has $25,000 left in it, and it keeps falling. Well, like I've done before on this channel, we've talked about USO. There is a lot of attorneys out there, and they say if you've lost more than $500,000, reach out to them. But it looks like you're not at $500,000 just yet. And that's why on this channel, kids, we have a thing called a stop losing all of your money. A stop loss. You put in a stop loss right about here. That's where my stop loss would have been if I were trading on the 4-hour. And you can put in a buy, and then you just move your stop up. Just keep moving it until it closes. Then you take your cash and you go to Disneyland that's not open. And last but not least, I always offer 3 codes for my courses. I have 1 course. Look at this. Look at that. $1,997. And another one. You can't see it. I don't even know which way to move. Move this way. $300. You get both of them. You get both of my courses for $197. And people always ask me, and if you want to know what this is, Dominate Amazon, you can actually learn how to create a company on Amazon and sell products. That's what I've done for over a decade. And for those of you that are like, I keep clicking the link, but it's not. It's 2 payments of 1. Nope, you got to get the codes. I give 3 codes a day. So turn those bell notifications on. I can't handle that many people in the course because I have to help you. My phone's always blown up and you're like, Johnny Bravo, I asked you a question. So feel free to grab that if it is still available, and I will see you tomorrow.